Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 30 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 58 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 59. You have an Azure subscription. Users access the resources in the subscription from either home or from customer sites. From home, users must establish a point-to-site VPN to access the Azure resources. The users on the customer sites access the Azure resources by using site-to-site VPNs. You have a line of business app named App1 that runs on several Azure virtual machines. The virtual machines run Windows Server 2016. You need to ensure that the connections to App1 are spread across all the virtual machines. What are two possible Azure services that you can use? So we are given five options. We have to choose two suitable services which can serve the purpose. So option A is an internal load balancer. So as we know, internal load balancer can distribute traffic among virtual machines, and also it can distribute traffic based on various algorithms such as round robin, least connections, and IP hash. Further, internal load balancer works on layer 4, or in other words, transport layer, and can distribute traffic within a virtual network. So that is a correct solution in this case, so we have selected it. Option B is public load balancer, and public load balancer is used to serve the internet facing application, and since our connectivity is available over the VPN for Azure resources, therefore it is not useful in this case. So we'll deselect it. Next one is an Azure Content Delivery Network. Azure Content Delivery Network offers a global solution for rapid delivering content over the internet. So that is also for public facing applications, not used for internal or application which is available over the VPN. Next one is Traffic Manager. Azure Traffic Manager is a DNS-based traffic load balancer, and this service allows to distribute traffic to public-facing applications across global Azure regions. So it's for a multiple region solution, and that is also public-facing application. So option E is layer 7 or application layer load balancer that can distribute traffic based on various criteria such as URL path, host headers, and cookie. It can also perform SSL offloading, session affinity, and URL based routing. So this could also be a good solution in our case, since it is more advanced than the internal load balancer, but it requires, you know, public IP address. So in this question, examiner is trying to understand or test our ability to decide services given a scenario that our connectivity is available for all the users over the VPN, and then what is the suitable solution which we can offer or select while the application is available over multiple virtual machines. Let's move to next question. Question number 60. You have an Azure subscription. You have 100 Azure virtual machines. You need to quickly identify underutilized virtual machines that can have their service tier changed to less expensive offering. Which blade should you use? So in this question, examiner would like to see our understanding for selecting a service to save the costing. So we can determine that what is underutilized and we can save some cost over it. So let's see the options available. Option A is Monitor, or in other words, Azure Monitor. Azure Monitor is a comprehensive monitoring solution for collecting, analyzing and responding to monitoring data from cloud and on-premise environment. This could not be a correct answer since it is not providing any help to save our cost in this case. So Azure Monitor is not the correct answer in this case. Let's see option B. In that case, we have Azure Advisor. And Azure Advisor is a personalized cloud consultant that helps follow best practices to optimize Azure deployments. It analyzes the resource configuration and uses telemetry and then recommends solutions that can help improve the cost effectiveness, performance, reliability and security of Azure resources. This could be a correct solution in that case, since it is helping us to improve the cost effectiveness as well as performance, reliability and security aspect of any Azure resource. And this is what we are looking for here, that we can reduce some cost. So option B is the correct option. Let's go to next option, option C, which is Matrices. Azure Monitor Matrices is a feature of Azure Monitor that collects the numeric data from monitored resources into time series database. That is also just collecting the data and not providing any advice as such. Therefore, it is also not the correct answer in this case. The option D is Azure Customer Insight. That enables organization of all sizes to bring together diverse data sets and generate knowledge and insights to build a holistic 360 view of their customers. Azure Customer Insights would not be correct answer, since it is a data management tool and it cannot be used to have advisory service. I hope this video was informative for you. Please like, subscribe and press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.